Now let us understand what are the components of aggregate demand. So let's begin with the first component, which is household consumption demand or expenditure. That's represented by C. See, household consumption, when I'm talking about this particular term, it refers to the total expenditure that would be incurred by households on purchase of goods and services. So in my Indian economy, if I have 1 million households, then household consumption demand would be the total expenditure done by these 1 million households, okay, on purchase of goods and services. This is also known as private consumption expenditure. How do I determine this particular consumption demand, that is household consumption demand or expenditure? I would determine that by the level of personal disposable income. So if my personal disposable income is high, then my consumption expenditure would be high. See, personal disposable income in very plain words is nothing but the income which is available in your hands so that you can spend. So once I get my salary, there are certain taxes to be paid, right? Then there would be certain statutory benefits which I would get. So I need, let's say for example, there would be compulsory PPF which I need to deposit with the government, or there would be certain cuts in my salary. So net net, when I receive my salary, what's the personal disposable income? That's it. How much money is left with me in my hands that I can spend? That is considered to be the personal disposable income. Now, investment expenditure by firms, that is I. Now, this refers to planned expenditure by private entrepreneurs. So this basically is an expenditure wherein they will go and buy fixed assets like plant, machinery. So that's creation of new capital assets such as raw material, machines, buildings, etc. Okay. Now remember, whenever such kind of investment expenditure is done, the economy grows through investment, because such kind of investment helps in increasing the output. Okay. Capital formation will result in increase in capital assets. Now, when I'm talking about the term capital formation, it is also known as private investment expenditure, and it comprises of investments in fixed assets and inventory stock. Okay. Now, higher the rate of interest in the market, that is market rate of interest, lower would be the investment expenditure, as the rate of interest is considered to be the cost of borrowing. See, as an entrepreneur, if I wish to buy a certain machinery, which I can go ahead and buy on debt. So then if my market rate of interest is very high, then probably I won't be able to afford it. What would happen because of that? I would not be able to do capital formation. Okay. Now, the next component here is government expenditure or demand for goods and services. Okay. So basically what happens here, even in an economy, the government would be spending some money or demanding certain goods and services. Okay. This would generally be the government's planned expenditure on purchase of consumer and capital goods. For example, the government is giving you or providing you infrastructure. They would be providing schools, making schools, transports, hospitals, roads, parks, etc. So for this, they would be demanding certain goods and services. So government expenditure also decides or contributes to aggregate demand. The next comes your net exports, which is X minus M. In plain words, it is exports minus imports. So basically, when I'm talking about the aggregate demand of all the goods and services which are being produced in the Indian economy and are demanded by the foreign economies, that would be my export, and the goods and services produced in other economies or foreign economies demanded by the people or households and firms in the Indian economy would be my imports. Okay. Now remember, these exports and imports would depend upon your foreign exchange rate. Like for example, if the foreign exchange rate is very high, then probably the import of goods and services would be less, right? Because they would be more costlier. In terms of trade policy, for example, what kind of trade policy they have, if the government is imposing certain duties, quotas, then that would make the goods and service expensive, and accordingly the demand would get shifted. Now remember, net exports can be positive, negative or zero. So you can go ahead and find out what is India's net export as of now, or maybe last fiscal year. Now if exports is greater than imports, obviously that means the net export is positive. So if in, let's say, the Indian economy has total export of $100 million, then, and the imports are $80 million, then here what would happen? The net exports would be $20 million, but positive. Now let's take exports being $50 million, imports being $100 million. So what is happening? The net export would be negative. Exports would be equal to imports when the, this scenario would be when both the numbers are equal, like both of them are 50 million each. So then net export would be zero. So these are the components of aggregate demand. So if I have to now give you a formula about these aggregate demand, it would be AD is equal to C plus I plus D plus X minus M. So this is how the aggregate demands components are set out or shown in a formula. C plus I plus D plus X minus M.